When we think of championship belts in wrestling, we think of beautiful designs. But apparently there are a few designs that would make championship belts look ugly. So, I, Bill Thompson, will be presenting a top 10 list of the ugliest championship belts in wrestling. At number 10, WCW Television Championship Belt. The whole concept of a television championship belt is for it to be defended on television. And I mean weekly television, a process that started with NWA sometime in the 70s. And that is the belt that you're looking at right here, the NWA belt. Specifically, it displays Network's logos of ABC, ABC, CBS, and another network. But to be honest, with WCW's television championship belt, what the heck were they thinking? This design? It's just plain bland, don't you think? This design kind of reminds me of the big gold belt of WCW. Oh, sure, it's got a nice design with fancy design you see on castles and stuff, but this belt is just full of orange. And where is the television set on this one? Jeez! That's very ugly, because of its design. Very cheesy, don't you think? And speaking of television championship belts, at number 9, the Ring of Honor Television Championship. Okay, I'm having a whole lot of business right now with television championship belts. I came across one that's very ugly. I mean, just look at it. At least it's got television on it, but Ring of Honor, what the... we're thinking of? I'm not so sure. This crappy design? I mean, it looks like a crushed classic WWE belt. I rest my case with that one. Wait, we got the WWE Tag Team Championship belts on Raw and SmackDown. What were they thinking about these belts? Understand why WWE went from this tag team championship belt to this one to these beautiful looking belts and this looking like a bunch of coins, especially when it became this for the Raw and Golden Bronze and for SmackDown Silver. How ugly are they? You be the judge on that. This next belt may give you freaks or something. And that is, of course, at number 7, the TNA Exhibition Championship belt. Who thought of this belt anyway? Let's be honest, the green on the belt makes it ugly. I mean, green might be a good belt, but not on this. Especially when the TNA Exhibition Championship was blue, but it being green, that could scare you, don't you think? Here's another belt that could be ugly to your eyes. At number 6, the ECW Silver Championship belt. I'm not a big fan of that one, don't you think? When WWE had to reactivate ECW, as a third brand, they brought only one belt back, and that is the ECW Championship belt. Which would eventually change design that would send the brand into obscurity forever. When ECW was relaunched, this belt, an update of their classic one was used, which didn't last long because in 2008 it was changed to a silver one. That sent the brand way off the deep end. We're at the halfway point with the fifth ugly belt. Number 5 is the WWE Big Gold Belt from 1991. Not a good belt design, don't you think? Now, earlier I mentioned the Big Gold Belt for WCW. It was rather the WWE, then WWF. Then when WWF got back, WWE made their own Big Gold Belt, which is the one you're about to see. It's not the real Big Gold Belt. Look at the font. And the design makes it look ugly. That's all I can say about that. And at number 4, holds the WWE Intercontinental Championship belt of 2012, a redesigned classic one. As I discovered about the classic WWE Intercontinental Championship belt being redesigned, the first version of it was ugly, don't you think? Redesigned this classic Intercontinental Championship belt. When it got redesigned in 2012, as shown here, unveiled by Cody Rhodes, it may look ugly, don't you think? Especially with the globes, latitude and longitude lines, in the opposite direction. At number 3, we got the WWE Championship belt on a blue strap, the Winged Eagle. Yeah, I know Ultimate Warrior wore it, but on a blue strap, this is ridiculous. This belt's ugly design, the strap that is, makes it look too cool. At number 2, it's WWE's Intercontinental belt by Goldust, a drag queen. God, speaking of colored straps, Goldust had one on the IC belt. Just a stupid color on a stupid belt. I'm kind of excited to say the Universal Championship of WWE as the number 1 belt. That's ugly. At SummerSlam 2016, they unveiled the new WWE Universal Championship belt. The crowd area booed at its design. However, is that? I'll explain along the way. Just look at this design. It's red all over, with a red logo, red strap. I mean, this is just bogus. WWE utilizes a championship belt based on this, and this, and this, and this. Who would have thought? I was expecting this one, but a round rubber championship belt? Please. I'm not too fond of that, though I am a big fan of red, but too much red, you won't see me wearing one. That's it.